Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. In an effort to better understand our changing planet and our impact on it, NASA kicked off its Earth Expeditions campaign on March 23rd. The project calls for 8 major new Earth science field experiments to take place over the next 6 months all around the world. The first of the new projects, the Oceans Melting Greenland investigation, is currently underway. It's looking at how much the oceans around Greenland are melting the edges of the ice sheet from below. Updates on the campaign will be provided on NASA's social media channels and the newly launched Earth Expeditions webpage. NASA uses ground-based field studies along with observations from space to gain a more complete picture of how and why our planet is changing. The 47th Annual Lunar and Planetary Science Conference, March 21st through 25th near Houston, featured a presentation by NASA's Director of Planetary Science, Jim Green, about the agency's planetary science activities, including this year's July 4th arrival at Jupiter of the Juno spacecraft and the launch of the OSIRIS-REx asteroid mission later this year. Other news from the conference included the release of some highly anticipated views of dwarf planet Ceres taken by the Dawn spacecraft from its lowest orbit yet at Ceres. The new images reveal that one of the puzzling bright spots inside of Akata crater appears to be a dome with crisscrossing fractures and other linear features. Meanwhile, members of the New Horizons mission discussed evidence that the long-term shifts and tilt of Pluto's orbit might have made it possible for rivers and lakes of liquid nitrogen to exist on the surface of the dwarf planet in the past, and maybe again in the future. NASA's Kepler Space Telescope has become the first observatory to capture the super bright flash of an exploding star's shockwave in the optical wavelength or visible spectrum. Researchers analyzing light captured by Kepler over a 3-year period say the phenomenon called the shock breakout happened in 2011 when a red supergiant star exploded while in Kepler's view. The star was roughly 500 times the size of our Sun and about 1.2 billion light years away. On March 22nd, Orbital ATK's Cygnus cargo spacecraft launched to the International Space Station from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station in Florida atop a United Launch Alliance Atlas V rocket. The nearly 7,500 pounds of cargo on board Cygnus included a large-scale fire science experiment, a study to perform the first space-based observations of meteors entering Earth's atmosphere, and the second generation of the 3D printer currently being used on the station. On March 25th, NASA astronaut Scott Kelly and cosmonauts Sergei Volkov and Mikhail Kornienko of Roscosmos participated in traditional welcoming ceremonies in Star City, Russia, several weeks after they returned to Earth from the International Space Station. NASA Administrator Charlie Bolden was among those on hand for the event. Kelly and Kornienko spent 340 days in space as part of a study on the effects of long-duration spaceflight on the human body. Data from that study will be used to formulate a human mission to Mars. NASA's International Space Apps Challenge will take place April 22nd through 24th with this year's global main stage located in Pasadena, California. Participants at 193 locations in 72 countries will use NASA data to develop mobile applications, software, hardware, data visualizations, and platform solutions that could contribute to space exploration missions and help improve life on Earth. The 3-day event is considered one of the largest hackathons in the world. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.